Awesome. Well, thank you for the early name drops, John and Lawrence, because I'm new to most of you. I think before I dive into the 125, I'll just give a little bit of background for those of you who don't know me, which is likely most of you. So I joined Golf Canada in the fall. I'm coming up on the end of my fifth month. So as you can imagine, I'm already deeply immersed in everything and fully knowledgeable on all topics. But, you know, really excited to be here, be part of this process, be part of the AGM. You know, I think I couldn't have actually joined at a better time. It was right at the end of the last season where I was able to really digest all of the post reports and really dive into planning for the coming season, which was really exciting. The other element was the first project I was actually given was the 125 project. And as somebody who comes from a brand and marketing background, I was really thrilled about it. So my immediate history is I spent 6 years at the CFL. As I like to say, I'm actually even worse at football than golf, so just for context, but spent many years there in a marketing and digital capacity. I developed the stat system there, two fantasy games, mobile games, another mobile app for the league itself, so very well versed in that side of things, as well as developing brand through both events and activations, and then wonderful things like you know, what we're about to celebrate here with our 125. I also worked on the rebrand while we were there, so lots of experience in that area. And then previous to that, I was at Chorus Entertainment, working on broadcast properties, and before that at Rogers Media and Rogers Communications. So certainly a lot of experience in that area. So very thrilled to have started here, and particularly with the initial kickoff project with the 125. You know, for me personally, what really resonated with me was considering the age of the organization, it is just not possible to separate the history of golf from the history of Golf Canada, which is so unique and so special. And so what you'll see in the coming days and months, and hopefully what you've even seen around here, is really integrating this celebration into every single one of our touch points. So that includes, you know, the logo that we've created and applying that across everything that we're going to be doing this year. But really, it actually goes, you know, far beyond that as well. You know, in each one of our functional areas, including heritage, and I will say Megan Gardner at our group has done a fantastic job at helping to lead this on our side as someone who is so deeply knowledgeable about Golf Canada and the history of the sport. So she is doing a tremendous amount of work, including working with politicians to get them on site for our RBC Hall of Fame Day, which will be dedicated to our 125. We'll have a letter from the Prime Minister. We have citations from the Governor General coming. So many wonderful things that we're able to wrap our hands around there. With our championships, again, it will be deeply integrated into everything that we're doing at our championships. We're going to do giveaways for the first 125 people on site. Get them there early, hopefully drinking a little bit more. So some of the commercial side for John there, including membership, of course. So we'll be doing activations with our membership and our clubs. So the top 125 scores we'll be awarding prizes on. We'll do virtual tournaments on June 6th, which is actually the founding of Golf Canada, 1895. So really, really interesting opportunities across the board in terms of some of our cross-functional groups. And Champs will actually have a traveling exhibit that will go across, you know, with Adam and his team and their many sleepless nights. So they'll have one more thing to do, but Adam seems to be game for it. But a great way to get this message across the country and through all of our events. Communications, so Dan and his team wonderfully are working with media and pitching those sort of key moments as part of our history so that we can actually tell and really share this story widely. You know, the foundation has also embraced this and will be doing activations around this from a fundraising perspective. On the marketing side, along with the comms team, we are creating a digital hub to honor the top 125 moments in our history, which there's been plenty of discussion over, as you would imagine. I think even Megan came up with more than 150, and we had a number of very lively discussions about what it should, how we should cut down to 125. Partnerships as well has been deeply involved in terms of getting, you know, the FootJoys involved and the level wares and how they're going to integrate into this as well. So just thrilled to have so many people across the board embrace this. So I'll just go through a couple of quick slides just to show you how some of this is actually going to look and feel and give you a taste of it, but you're going to see this roll out in the days to come. So here are just some of the ways that we're integrating this into some of our product on site. Our website's still a work in progress, but is going to be launched with those top 125 moments. And then you probably saw some of these outside as well, and these are honoring our top 125 moments as well. And we'll be able to actually take these to our events across the country throughout the year. So just really excited to bring this to life throughout the entire season and really, really embrace it because this is so monumental for us. So I think I'll move onward to, you know, what Lawrence and John had both referenced, which is really the digital marketing side of things. So from a digital marketing perspective, I mean, certainly this is my strength and expertise. This is my background. I've done this for about 10 years. It's a very lively space. And one of the things, I think it's actually why I gravitated to sports even, because digital marketing, it lets you keep score, which is one of my favorite things about it. You really get that real-time feedback. And so really diving into the digital marketing side of things, in particular around the public player. And so I'm going to dive into that very, very specifically. So when I first started, this had obviously been a top priority for the organization for some time. And as I was really getting myself up to speed in terms of what this meant, what our objectives were, one of the things was a little bit clear to me in that we didn't necessarily have the data to support what would be a really robust strategy and a path to a really effective go-to-market campaign. So I guess it would have been in partnership with Golf Ontario as well as the rest of the provinces. It would have been, I'm going to say, November. We were out in market with an RFP to engage with an agency to truly understand the public player from many different facets. So what are their triggers for playing? What are some of the barriers? What are there some of the behaviors outside of that world of golf so that we could actually truly identify who these people are and message to them effectively? So this has been ongoing since November. We had the research back in October, and since then we've really been synthesizing that and taking that and really applying it to what is essentially our roadmap going forward. So I'm going to flip ahead. Here we go. So from a marketing standpoint, you just really can't have a sophisticated marketing strategy without understanding the consumer. And really, that's what this is all about. How do we actually understand the consumer in a really deep, deep way? And then how do we take those learnings and those insights and action them? So that's all what's been happening here. And in fact, there's going to be a panel about this tomorrow. So I'm not going to reveal too much because I want everyone to show up at the panel tomorrow. So I'm going to touch on this, hopefully excite you a little bit, and then everyone's going to be up bright and early, 9 o'clock in this room. So I hope to see everybody there. And then in terms of our go-to-market, I mean, really this is about flawless execution. And that is, again, why I love digital. You have a really great feedback system. So we've really developed a really great plan and strategy in terms of executing this, which we're going to go into detail tomorrow. So we'll get into that then. We'll see you all bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. So the second element of this is digital products. So as I mentioned, I have a very strong digital product background. And what's really underestimated is how much that actually is marketing. A digital product actually is a marketing tool. So when I look at the current product set that we have, the digital ecosystem, there is so much that we can do there to enhance it, to engage our users, and to get them to engage further with us. So we are currently in the process of developing a very defined roadmap against the public player, particularly, but also with our current members, to get them further engaged, in our ecosystem so that we can actually get them in, get in front of them with our programs. So our Future Links programs or some of the initiatives we're doing around the foundation. The more people we can get engaged on our websites, on our apps, the more that we can actually speak to our top priorities and have them engage more deeply with us. So that strategy and that roadmap is currently underway, and I'm really going to be excited to share that with you in the coming weeks and months. I will say this is a very consumer-focused strategy. This is really about how we get people in those products and engage with them. That is going to be the absolute critical piece of it and driving that engagement. So very, very, very critical, and it leads so much to this next point. So data services. So with these digital products, one of the key elements that we're looking to do is how do we actually capture data through this? So if somebody wants to engage with us through an app, whether they're a member or non-member, we want to be collecting information and data about those individuals. This will actually allow us to understand our consumers in a much better, deeper, richer way and inform us on how to actually pivot our thinking, our products, our approach on things. These things evolve over time, user habits, user behaviors. But when we have those real-time interactions with people, with our consumer, they're telling us every day what they want, and they're doing it through those actions. So these products will allow us to assess those actions and understand how we can actually further engage them and get them more deeply involved in our business. They care about golf, we know that, but how do we get them to be part of the greater picture, whether that is getting kids involved, whether that's, you know, working with the foundation. So many opportunities on that front. It's also about tailoring and targeting our message. So this goes back to the research piece. The best thing I can do as a marketer is understand what the message that I need to deliver to you to convert on what I want to convert on. And this isn't about duping anybody. This is actually finding the people who do want your service. So that is a really important element when I think about digital products, is being able to actually fill out that data set to allow me to properly identify who's actually going to convert on the things they actually want. I'm not, one of those marketers trying to sell something to people who don't want it. To me, that's a waste of money. I'm going to spend a ton of money, and I'm going to lose those people pretty quickly. So the other element of the data services, and this is something that I would love to work collectively with everybody in this room on, and is something I've really been, I would say, sort of workshopping over the last couple of weeks. I'm, again, still relatively new. But I'm going to give you a really small example of something that just recently came up. And what I'd love to do is have the individuals in this room really think about it and think about how we could actually collaborate on this notion and in fact, make it bigger, make it more refined. So the example I'm going to give is that there was a golf course, and they are working on trying to get more people into the golf course. So I did an interesting sort of experiment. I said, let me look at something and let me see how I can get back to you. Some of their feedback to me was they had done some very broad marketing, but essentially they were feeling like they're looking for a little bit of a needle in a haystack. They can't quite find their target that they're looking for. So a lot of their campaigns were, while they were delivering something, they were not delivering what they should be delivering from a sort of return on ad spend perspective. So I actually had a look at our CRM. I looked at our public players. So we have, if 20% of our members are currently public players. And I looked at, okay, who of those public players are in a 3-kilometer radius of this facility? And I was actually able to identify 142 names, the top of which had actually played 92 rounds last year, which is, tell me who has that kind of time, but I mean, I love it. But what I'm able to do then is now I'm able to work with these individuals and actually deploy a campaign through our channels very specifically for them. And my message to them was, yes, I know you're looking for a needle in a haystack, but I think I might have a list of needles. And so while all these individuals might not necessarily convert to the specific campaign that you're actioning, I actually have a very, very qualified lead list. So I haven't, again, quite thought through all of, you know, what this means, what the power of this is, but I wanted to bring it up to this group in particular because I think there could be a huge opportunity here, and especially as we look to grow the public player base, we really do want to look at this as how can Golf Canada be a service to all of our constituents? And that's just one small example of how I really want to look to be a service to all the constituents in this room. So again, I will leave that point with you just so you can think about it a little bit, chew it over, but happy to chat with anyone afterwards because I think there's no shortage of opportunity, and I think that if we collaborate together, we can really impact each other's businesses. So that's it for me. I think I probably took a little bit longer than I should have, but thank you so much. I look forward to meeting everybody.